Great to see you again, Ted. How many people actually call you Shred? I mean, I know that's what it's listed, but do your buddies call you that, or what do they really call you out there?
For the most part, people just call me Ted. but growing up, I had some coaches that called me Shred. And
what's your favorite sport?
Skiing.
Some friends still do call me Shred, and some coaches as well.
Is that that okay with you? Cool.
That's fine. Yeah, of course. I'm always happy to be called Shred.
Yeah. What do the Europeans call you over there, other than you know, unbeatable?
I actually have a lot of guys calling me Teddy on the World Cup, which is kind of funny because, you know, that's what I guess my parents called me when I was a little kid.
Well, how is Switzerland right now? I know you're getting ready for another World Cup run over there. How's Adelboden?
Adelboden's good. They have snow in the race, which is a positive. It's on the warm side. It's kind of snowing and raining right now, so they canceled the hill free ski, unfortunately, but hopefully it should be a good race. It's a really cool hill. It's one of the most classic World Cups on the tour. They've been having it for, I don't know, 80-something years almost, so it's one of the cool ones to win for sure. So hopefully I can try to win it for the first time on Saturday.
Yeah. Well, win it for the first time is something that's kind of foreign to have you say, because you have been just rolling. You're hunting a 15th giant slalom win in the World Cup world. Can you tell us what it's like? I mean, I've talked to athletes who are in the zone, supposedly. What's it like for you? Is it all quiet? Everything slows down? A combination of all that? I mean, I know the confidence right now has to be just oozing.
I definitely have a lot of confidence, especially in my GS skiing. It's going well. I think when I'm actually racing, I'm not thinking about anything but going hard at the next gate. You know, I'm basically blank for the most part in the start gate. I actually get kind of anxious a little bit sometimes. So up until, you know, about a minute before I go to the start gate, I try to distract myself a little bit. And then the leading seconds when I race, I definitely focus in, and then pretty much just blank the whole way down.
Is that distracting yourself just about kind of keeping it real, trying to, like for me, sometimes if I'm nervous on TV, I just try to laugh or find a way to smile or laugh or get myself through that moment? What are you exactly are you doing in that moment when you're trying to just, you know, power down?
Yeah, I just joke with my servicemen, a couple other athletes on the hill that I'm friends with as well. So try to keep the starting area light atmosphere.
Mm. Yeah. All right. Well, tell us about this really cool project coming up here Sunday here on KSL and NBC. It'll air 1:30 Mountain Time here. U.S. Ski Team 36. But it's let's be honest, it's about you.
Yeah.
Today we tour the Italian Alps with Ted Ligety as he races the most prestigious giant slalom on the World Cup.
It was pretty neat. They followed me around for about 2 days leading up to the Adelboden race or Alta Badia race in December. And they're following me 24/7. So basically, when I woke up and crawled out of bed to doing warm up, to eating breakfast, to racing and being on the hill, they're there all the time, which is definitely something that gets some taking used to, because you know, it's weird having the microphone on you at all time, and you have to, you know, watch what you say a little bit, because, you know, we don't always use perfect grammar, let's call it that.
Exactly.
Amongst all the ski guys, so it's something that they used to, but it's a fun experience as well, and I think it's really cool to have that kind of inside look into ski racing, because we don't really get that kind of opportunity, especially in front of such a big crowd like NBC has.
Yeah, well, it's remarkable. I just have seen the trailer, which people are seeing right now as we show it. But take us through that feeling. I mean, I don't know how much of you've seen, but how cool it is when you get a chance to kick back and reflect on, wow, they jammed 36 hours down into an hour. And I mean, it's the best, it's quick, it's fast paced. It gets your emotion in there. They cut out, they edit out some of the stuff you don't want in there, of course.
They did send me a rough cut of it, so I've seen a little bit of it, and it's pretty cool. You know, I was really glad that I ended up winning the race, because it would have really put a damper on the show if I had done poorly. So that was definitely a good thing, and it's cool to check that out, because it's definitely different from stuff we normally get to see about ourselves.
Yeah, and for all of us here in Utah, a great chance to see you. You know, sometimes unless we're watching Universal or unless we're keyed in, you know, you guys are kind of out of sight, out of mind over there in Europe. I mean, you're huge over there, but, you know, with the Olympics a year out, it's starting to ramp back up. So this is a great opportunity for those of us in the U.S. and here in Utah to get a chance to kick back and watch you do what you do. And like you said, you know, you crushed it over there.
Yeah, it was a really cool experience. And, yeah, anytime we can get on you know, the national networks for ski racing, it's a huge part, and especially with leading up to the Olympics, and we have World Championships this year in Schladming, Austria, too, so that's something we're gearing up for as well, but a lot of World Cup racing in between here and there.
Well, you have done what athletes really fear. You are in everybody's head, and I among the marvels that I've read, all the quotes, the Swede Hans Olsen said, quote, just in, Marvel Pictures going to make a new movie about a superhero. It's not the Hulk, the Spider-Man, or Batman. It's about Ted Ligety.
It's like that are pretty cool to hear from your competitors, but you know, even though 2 seconds is a huge margin in ski racing, I think it's you know, it's still pretty small. You can lose 2 seconds quickly, so it's not something I'm resting on and being super comfortable. I know I still have a lot of work ahead of me if I want to continue at the pace I'm going, so not resting easy at this point.
No, of course not. That's the champion in you. It's a little bit of the, you know, the fear of failure that drives all of us, but it's like Lindsay almost now. I mean, do you appreciate that you're in other people's heads, or I don't know if you'll admit that, but I mean, any athlete wants to know that everybody else is watching you going, whoa, this guy's, you know, we're all chasing him, and I don't know if we can catch him. They're talking about your equipment. You know, they're complaining about everything. You got to love that.
It is definitely a cool feeling. I think that's every athlete's goal, is to be at the level where guys think they're unbeatable. I think, you know, I don't consider myself unbeatable, but that's definitely a step in the right direction if some of my biggest rivals are saying that.
All right, we're a year out, and I know, you know, your first Olympic experience, Torino, the first time you were on the big stage and with a chance. I mean, again, you won the combined gold medal just kind of out of nowhere, and then you went to Vancouver, and I was with you in a little bit of not great conditions there at Whistler, and maybe a disappointment, but now you look ahead to Sochi. It's a year out, and it's a long way, and there's a lot of stuff that can happen, but you have to be about exactly where you want to be.
I'm really happy with where I am. Hopefully I can keep this going. It's too bad it's not the Olympic year and I'm skiing like I am right now. So that would make it even better. So hopefully I can continue at this level going through next year. And yeah, like you said, my Olympic experiences have been pretty varied with winning a gold medal in 2006 and then walking away winless or even medalless in Vancouver was definitely a disappointment. And I think that's been a good motivator for me in the last couple of years as well as is that disappointing performance there, and that's really driven me, I think. So hopefully I can keep that drive and keep the results and the skiing coming along as it is.
Yeah, that's great. Certainly motivating. As we go out the door, anything you want to say to your people back here in Park City? I know you were just back here for Christmas. I don't know if you're not going to get back for the Sundance Film Festival. You'll miss another one of those.
Yeah, being home for Christmas is awesome. It was great to have a couple powder days in, and it's so nice to just be in Park City in general. It's a cool place to be, and unfortunately, I don't get to spend too many winters there. So,
right.
Yeah, just say hi to all my friends and family there, and hopefully they get some good skiing in for me, and hopefully it's still a good ski season still when I get back home in April.
That's
so
right.
I can get some more late powder.
Again, U.S. Ski Team 36 coming up Sunday on NBC and KSL, 1:30 Mountain Time. Get a chance to see Ted crush it in Italy, and best of luck here this weekend in Switzerland.
Thanks. Have a good one.
Yeah, you too. Thanks.